الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وبعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. I welcome you to our program Wisdom Talks every Monday to Friday from 3 o'clock until 3:30 p.m. Yesterday, brothers and sisters, I spoke a bit about the last and final sermon of our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And today I'd like to continue where I left off from yesterday. But you know, just quickly going over what I spoke about yesterday, the Prophet first spoke about how he does not know after this sermon whether he'll be amongst us or not, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After that, he spoke about the importance of passing this message to others. He spoke about the importance of guarding the life and the trust of a Muslim as a sacred trust. He spoke about the importance of not tampering the calendar, the Islamic calendar, and actually the importance, showing us the importance of, you know, having that connection to our calendar. He spoke about being aware from shaitan, you know, staying away from shaitan, leaving the small, you know, the small temptations, the small things he does in order to misguide us. And this is his main tactic, as the Prophet highlights, that he uses the small actions to lead us to the big actions. And the Prophet also spoke about the importance of being kind to women, realizing that they are not your slaves, but they are your partners and committed helpers. Now the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he continues, and I quote, "O people, listen to me in earnest. Worship Allah, say your 5 daily prayers, fast during the month of Ramadan, and give your wealth in zakat. Perform hajj if you can afford to." So these are the basic. As you see, the Prophet, just before he's leaving this world, he is leaving us, he's stressing on the basic. And as long as we don't focus on the basic, we don't focus on perfecting the basics of Islam, we will never achieve a proper state of Iman. Our faith will always be in trivia. We will always be a bad example for others. We will always misrepresent Islam. So it's important that you and I, we stress on the basic. We review our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the basics that the Holy Prophet is actually stressing on. And he's leaving us with practical aspects, not with just some theoretical speech. You know, normally if a person knows it's his last sermon, then he will try in order to convey the best message that he can. And likewise, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he knew that it might be very well his last sermon. And this is why he's leaving us with very, very important chunks of information. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he continues and says, "All of mankind is from Adam and Eve. An Arab has no superiority over a non-Arab, nor a non-Arab has any superiority over an Arab. Also, a white has no superiority over a black, nor a black has any superiority over a white, except by piety and good action." A very important statement, highlighting racism. A thousand years before anyone else thought about this issue even, the difference between black and white. You know, this nationalism that some Arabs have inside of them. This nationalism that, in fact, the whole Muslim world has. We all have this nationalism. We all have, you know, a lot of people have this racism. Racism has declined so much in our society today, alhamdulillah. But still, bits and pieces of racism are in the people's hearts. And in order for us to achieve a society of mutual cooperation, it is important that we remove these elements of racism. And we learn to respect each other, each other's values, each other's choices. Nationalism is not something that we should be proud of. We shouldn't, you know, consider ourselves over other individuals. The only thing that makes a person better than another person is how pious he is, how many good actions he has. But who decides that by the end of the day? Not you, not me. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continues, "Learn that every Muslim is a brother to every Muslim. And all Muslims constitute one brotherhood. They don't become this, they don't become that. They don't join this sect, they don't join that sect. We all constitute one brotherhood." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Nothing shall be legitimate to a Muslim which belongs to a fellow Muslim unless it was given freely and willingly." Look at this. The Prophet again, he emphasizes the importance of guarding a person's trust. Something that if a person doesn't have, in fact, is a characteristic of hypocrisy. And it is something that is so common today in the world that we live in, that we're not guarding each other's trust. We're not respecting each other's property. "Do not therefore do injustice to yourself. Remember, one day you will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and answer your deed. So beware. Do not astray from the path of righteousness after I am gone." Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember this, brothers and sisters. This piece of advice Christ. I'm not giving you. Your prophet, the one you claim to love, the one I claim to love, it is he who's giving us this message. How many people today are far away from the truth of his message? How many people are attempting to distort the message that he has brought us? Until you and I, instead of us complaining about the problems of this world, it is about time that the change we want to see in this world, we should bring that change first within our own self. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says very, very importantly, O people, no prophet or apostle will come after me and no new faith will be born. O people, no prophet or apostle will come after me and no new faith will be born. One sentence rejects all those sects of Islam that say that there is a prophet or a messiah after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the greatest lie that there could be. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum. I have perfected your religion. How? This is the greatest insult to the Prophet. If he say he needs an apostle or a prophet after him, we're denying the perfection of his message. This is the greatest insult that a person can do to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And brothers and sisters, as usual that we have with the shortage of time, I'm unable to complete this very, very profound and detailed sermon of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And tomorrow, the last two paragraphs that I'll read, that I'll expand upon. In fact, I encourage you tonight that you go home. If you can read the whole sermon, at least read the last two paragraphs, because this is like the cream of the cake. This is like, these words are so important that if you and I, the Muslims, just understand these basic words, then you can say 90% of our problems are solved automatically. 90% of our confusions, or even 100% of our confusions, are gone on the spot. So tomorrow will be a very important program, inshallah. Please do listen, as I will be speaking about the last two paragraphs of the sermon of our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And as I said, these aren't my words. These aren't only the opinions of our program. These are the words of the Prophet himself. And if you and I, we believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then we cannot even reject a single sentence that has been uttered by his mouth. Subhanakallah bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.